Once your network is up and running and you're ready to accept remote connections, you want to ensure that you implement the appropriate security controls. You don't want to just let anyone in. You want to make sure you identify and authorize the appropriate users. You need to put in the controls to prevent unwanted access and to detect unwanted access. So let's take a few minutes and look at the various methods that you can use to control remote access to your network.